ideal quantum computer can break the encryption standards we use today by finding prime factors of a large integer in just minutes instead of the thousands of years it would take for a classical computer to do. But before you start to panic, while we have real quantum hardware today, it's not quite powerful enough to do that just yet. However, technologies are advancing faster than ever. The cell phones we have today are more powerful than the mainframes that we use to send people to the moon. And researchers believe that we will soon entering an era of quantum advantage, where quantum computers will be used to accelerate classical computers, just like GPUs. In this video, I'm going to talk about five foundational topics in quantum computer: superposition, gates, measurement, interference, and entanglement. But before we dive into that, let's first talk about bits. Classical computers use bits, which are like switches that can be a zero or a one. This way of computation has served us well, so well in fact that almost all modern computers work this way. However, this approach doesn't solve all the problems that we have today. Problems that can blow up exponentially and would take classical computers decades or more to solve. We already talk about the algorithm we use for encryption. Other types of difficult problems include optimization, chemistry simulation, and machine learning. Now let's talk about our first topic, superposition. Quantum computer does not use the simple 0 and 1 bits. Instead, it uses qubits. A qubit can be a 0, a 1, or any linear combination of the two. This spectrum of states is what we called a superposition. Our next topic is about gates. Similar to classical computers, we string together qubits using a construct called gates that can alter the states of qubits in the circuit. For example, we can have a qubit that's at the state of 0. Then we can use the Hadamard gate, or H gate for short, to put it in a superposition between 0 and 1. And of course, you can have multiple qubits with multiple gates in a circuit. For the circuit to be useful, at some point you need to read about its outputs, which brings us to our next topic, measurement. When a qubit is measured, it loses its superposition and collapse into just a simple 0 or 1. That means an arrow pointing this way does not measure a 0.5. Instead, it has 50% chance of measuring a 0 and 50% chance of measuring a 1. It is this in-between state that sometimes people say that a qubit can be a 0 and a 1 at the same time. It also means that just a small number of qubits can represent a large amount of information. So for our next topic, interference, we begin by addressing a common question. Why is that quantum computers can outperform classical ones? So if you remember, a quantum state is a linear combination of the zero state in the one state. So an operation applied to this can be seen as applying to the zero state and the one state, doing two calculations at once. It is this parallel computation that gives quantum its unique advantage. However, as you may recall, when a qubit is measured, it loses its superposition and collapses into 0 or 1. That means we can only get a single answer instead of all of the answers from this parallel computation. And to make sure the single answer we get is the correct one, quantum gates need to be arranged in a way so that it would amplify the correct answer and cancel out the incorrect ones, a process called interference. Now, this leads us to our last topic, entanglement. When qubits are entangled, their states become strongly correlated. That is, changing the state of just one qubit will change the state of another. For example, we can entangle two qubits so that their states have a 50% chance of measuring a 0-0 and 50% chance of measuring a 1-1, but never a 0-1 or a 1-0. In this case, if we change the state of one, the other one would also change. So with the combined power of superposition, interference, and entanglement, quantum computer can solve things that classical computers simply cannot do today. It can lead to better drug discovery, or enhanced stock portfolio, or even artificial intelligence. Now we just need to wait for the quantum hardware to catch up. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Also, please remember to like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to bring you content that matters to you.